talking about exploit development technique called egg hunting. I think everyone knows about assembly. Anyone have any basic idea about what assembly language is? Let's go through the basics first for a second. So this is assembly language. Normally CPU doesn't understand our language and we can't speak CPU language. So assembler works our instructions and translate it into machine language. We can execute our program very well. This is normally. These are the normal instructions. Move X or A. See how we can do that. Normal program, C program, which is vulnerable to buffer overflow. Consider this. We have declared here a buffer of five characters. It can store up to 5 characters. Okay, and it would check for password. This is another. This program can store up to 15 bytes of data in this buffer. initially pass equal to 0, prompts user for password, checks, compare. Okay. And just normally prints. What it does, consider this. Here we have integer password adjacent to this buffer of 15 bytes. Okay. If we store more than 15 bytes data in this buffer, it will upload into this password field integer, and it will override it. So let's consider we have junk data of around 15 bytes, and 16th byte is our integer 1. So it will flow into this password integer, and it would convert it to pass equal to 1. And here it will check, and it will prompt that this password is correct. Okay. But it's more like basic. It would result into segmentation fault and prompt program 2. Okay. So what is hijack? Consider there is a program which has around memory of 503 bytes free where you can write. Okay, but your shell code is around 800 bytes. What will you do? Shell code generally क्या होता है कि कोई भी instruction है आपको अगर calculator open करवाना है user के desktop पे तो उसका मशीन कोड होगा एसएमई में कंपाइल करके जो बाइनरी मशीन कोड होगा वो शेल कोड होगा वो हम बफर में मतलब इंस्ट्रक्शन को उससे एग्जीक्यूट करेंगे तो वो एग्जीक्यूट होगा और देन इट विल प्रॉम्प्ट फॉर कैलकुलेटर और व्हाटएवर वी आर एग्जीक्यूटिंग बट समटाइम्स वी डोंट हैव स्टोरेज फॉर नॉर्मल पीसीबी रिवर्स शेल यू नीड अराउंड 300 समथिंग बाइट्स बट समटाइम्स वी डोंट हैव दैट मच स्टोरेज इन अ प्रोग्राम it can allow something for around 30 bytes, 50 bytes. What can you do? So we can use that egg hunting techniques. It's stack shell code. It's divided in two series. So you can use a custom shell code of smaller amount, and it would find your larger shell code in anywhere in the memory where you have stored it. Okay, so you are using, in short, you are using 30 byte something shell code to find your 500 byte shell code and execute it. Yeah. This is normal EIP overwrite, what we saw in buffer overflow, right? EIP is overwritten, then it will jump to our shell code. We are giving it shell code and then it will be executed. This is our ESP. We have this much storage available and our shell code is of this size. So it fits perfectly in normal cases of buffer also. But what if we have ESP of small size but shell code is bigger? It won't work. A shell code is broken in pieces. So it's not able to do exactly what we want. So you can't have buffer overflow if you don't have any memory left. Egg hunter implementation. What it does, creatively this egg hunter, just search for this egg. Okay, so it is perfectly fitted in this ESP, like egg is normally around 30 to 40 bytes. So EIP then points to this egg hunter. Egg hunter will then execute and search for this egg in rest of the memory. It will search, if found shell code, then it will be executed and give whatever result you want. Okay. If buffer is too small, we can use that. This is vulnerable application, Colibri 2.0. We will try to exploit it on Windows XP. Okay. Just I'll try to set up. This is our web server. It just provides web page. It is blank, listens on port 80. Start. Let's see IP address of this. Okay, 192.168.43.99. Thank you. we will try to fuzz it first. This is a Python script for fuzzing. It imports three modules, socket, OS, system, junk of 600A. Everyone is familiar with Python. So this is normal packet for a web request. It includes a head, HTTP, whatever host. But we have included our junk over here, right with head. And we will try to inject 600A into that. And we will change IP address first. So it will connect to this machine, web server. 220. It will connect on port 80 and try to send this complete buffer, which contains 600 characters of A. First, let's attach this to immunity. Just a normal debugger. It could analyze the registers on current running program. So it is executed. Server is running now. Now let's try to send this 600 bytes. Send. So just a second. Wi-Fi na nila, like Wi-Fi nila sa tuwa siya. So, we can see that our program is now crashed. We can't just open it. And let's see this. ESP, EBX. It's all overwritten with 41414141, which is in AAA. You can see this here. ASCII. AAA. So in short, we have overwritten our ESP with and EIP, which matters most. EIP with this memory address 414141, which doesn't actually exist in our memory anywhere. So it would just crash with access violation. So we can say that this application, this server is vulnerable.
Now let's try to do something more. Everyone have used Metasploit here, correct? Metasploit framework. So this is a part of pattern create. It just creates a cyclic pattern. Instead of sending random A, we can create this string and send it to our target. So we can identify where we want to inject our shell code, like where it actually gets into. So just that difference. Access violation. So we have sent over a string successfully to this, and it has overwritten this. Yeah. Instead of A, we have this specific pattern of AR, 3AR, whatever. From this, we can identify exactly what memory location we want to inject. Exact map offset. Do you guys know about that? And this is really great functionality of immunity debugger, Mono extension. It just helps with exploit development. So you wanna find MSP. What it will do, it's just find our Metasploit pattern in our memory. It will just show a cyclic pattern found. It examines the resistors, and in EIB it contains normal pattern. Offset is 515. So if you want to inject our shell code, first 515 bytes are just not considered. So after that 516 byte, it would consider it would overwrite in that our specific program, and it would count as an exploit. So we would try to overwrite that. Find that. access violation. We have found Metasploit pattern. So this instruction will just search for jump for register ESP in all memory. Returning to the file. This DLL MSVCRT, it contains our instruction, and but we have our other requirements like ASLR should be disabled and everything like that. We don't need SCH for right now, so it's true, doesn't matter. So we would take its address. C3545 Okay, this is the address, but we normally work in little endian format in Intel processor. So when we write it, we want to write it to program, it would be like this. It would be like this. First, our offset is 515, so we will write 515A's, then this instruction, and so it would what it would do that then it would execute this instruction. This directly just means jump to ESP, and the rest B into 2, there are 2 B, and it would just try to execute 2 B's. So we would just see if that works. Access violation. So look at this. Here we have we had AAA, instead we just got BE. So it is what our instruction would be, where it should be. But here we can only inject some little bytes of data. We don't have much memory to include complete shell code. So what we can do? We can we can put our egg hunter there, and include our main shell code with tag. Let's see what's that first, actually. have written EB, C4, okay? We can't write anything beyond that. But it doesn't mean we can't write in back like A515. So we need to our EIB to jump back to this A515. So that's why we will need a jump instruction. And our egg hunter might be around 60 bytes of size. So we will need 60 bytes. So we are jumping back. So minus 60, which is XC4. And instruction XE is normal short jump. We are using that to make our very small. Overwritten here, EIB, the next instruction of an access violation means our this was successful. Now let's try something new. This is our egg hunter. We have our tag null. This egg hunter will search complete memory for this word and null. This is our buffer, our main shell code, which would start a TCP listener on our victim. Okay, so we combine this. So first. 478 bytes. As we said, it would go back and try to execute 60 something bytes. Our total code is around 32 bytes. So we manage it somewhere here. So 32, 478, 515 around. And our stage two buffer is null. We need to include our tag before the buffer starts. So it would search for our tag in the memory. And this is our main payload buffer. It would send this packet request where in stage 1 we have our hunter and in stage 2 we have our main shell code which would execute and result into final remote code execution. Started. Just sending bytes to this. So what we did, we can generate that egg with mona egg t, which is tag null, password or tag, whatever we want to search it, just in the functionality of mona. So we can generate our main payload with MSF vnum, another functionality of Metasploit. We have MSF vnum command, architecture, x86 CPU, platform for Windows, and this is our payload normal, Windows TCP bind. And when this shellcode is executed in our victim machine, it would open 9988 port on that victim, and it is encoded with alpha mix. So we can run this. Actually port, I was using different port, so we got our reverse connection over here. This is over direct, so successfully exploited, finally at least. So thanks, any questions? Start finding, it would search for null, it would find that and then starts executing whatever is after that. Mm-hmm. So shellcode execution. These are normal resources you can learn better. Yeah.
Thanks.